Hello everyone, welcome back. In the last video we had seen how to write a regular expression for a given statement. Today we see how to construct a finite state machine for a given regular expression. So according to the Kleene's theorem, there exists a finite state machine for every regular expression. So we already know null is also a regular expression, epsilon is also a regular expression. The expression may contain a single character, or the expression may combine two expressions, or it is a union of two expression, or it may be a clean closure. So we had considered all these cases, and here we see how to construct a finite state machine for these regular expression. So first one represent the null here. So null indicate what? It is not contributing anything to the language. So that is represented by two states, Q0 and QF. Q0 is a start state where QF is a final state. So we had not shown any transition between these two because it is a null. So it is not having any transition in the language, or it is not contributing any strings in the language. So it is shown by FSM where we have two states and there is a no transition. Next, the second one is the FSM which represent the epsilon. So epsilon indicate what? It contribute a null string to a language. So here null string is represented by a epsilon. So there is a start state, there is a final state, and I had shown the transition for a empty string. So empty string is represented by this epsilon. So epsilon indicate here empty string. So without any character, you are changing the state to a final state. So that is represented by this epsilon. Next, the third one is, it is a finite state machine to accept a single character, that is A. So we have a start state Q0. Next, we are changing the state to a final state if A occur. A is a single character present in the regular expression. So this FSM accept what? A strings of A's. Next, the fourth one is, see here the regular expression, representation of a regular expression. So whole regular expression is represent, see how your machine look, FSM machine look. So it is a machine where it has a Q and F, where Q is a start state and F is a final state. So this is a representation of your regular expression. Next, the case one, where I am concatenating, or you can say I am taking the union of R1 and R2. So what is R1 here? R1 is a regular expression that I am going to combine with what? R2. And that will be my resultant R here. So how to draw a FSM for this? See, here I had taken a two machine. So one first machine represent the regular expression one. Second machine represent the regular expression two. So I am going to combine these two machine with a new, by introducing the new start state and final state. And these start state I am going to connect to a first machine start state, and second transition is towards the second machine start state. Next, the final states of both machines are connected to the new introduced final state. So machine, when I say the machine, so machine has a start state, it has a final state. And what M contains? M contains the expression present in that regular expression. So here, so when they ask you to construct a finite state machine by combining the two regular expression, or you can say the union of two regular expression. So instead of plus, they can give a union symbol also. So R1 union R2. So I am combining two regular expression, and that is represented by this. So here we'll see that, we'll take the example and we'll see. Assume that the given regular expression is A plus B. So A is what? It is one regular expression where A is a alphabet which is accepted, and in another regular expression which is accepting the B alphabet. So how to construct a machine for this? So A plus B, or A union B. So according to this case one, first I should write a machine, or to draw the machine which accept the first regular expression, that is A. So I'll write a machine to accept what? A. Next, I should write a machine to accept what? B. So this is a machine I had drawn. Next, I am going to introduce a new start state and a new final state. So check out, this is a start state for this machine, this is a final state for this machine, and A is a what? The symbol that I am accepting in a first regular expression. This is a B symbol that I am accepting in a second regular expression. So according to this, I must introduce a new start state and new final state. So I had introduced new start state and new final state. So next, I am going to connect the start state to a start state of first machine. Same I am going to do for a second machine, and final states of these two machines I am going to connect to a newly introduced final state. So this is a FSM. Next, I am going to name this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is a finite state machine for a given regular expression A plus B or A union B. Next, if the regular expression has a concatenation, that is R equal to R1 dot R2, concatenation, or we can say the intersection, so R1 dot R2, so how to construct a machine for this? So first, you are going to construct a machine to accept the R1. Next, you are going to construct the machine which accept the regular expression 2. Then the first machine final state you are going to connect to the second machine start state by using a epsilon transition. So the first regular expression start state will be the start state of the whole FSM, and the second regular expression final state will be the final state for the given regular expression. So these two are combined with the final state of first regular expression is combined with the, or you are going to connect with the start state of second regular expression with the epsilon transition. So we'll take an example. So A dot B. So how to construct a machine for this? So this is a machine which accept the A. Next, this is a machine which accept B. Next, so this is a start state of the FSM. So the final state of first regular expression I am going to connect with the start state of next regular expression with the epsilon transition. And the final state of this will be the final state of whole FSM. So I am going to name this. So this is a finite state machine for a given regular expression A dot B. Next, the seventh one is how to represent, how to draw the finite state machine for clean closure, that is R1 star. So R1 star indicate what? The whatever the expression R1 is there, that will occur 0 or any number of times. So how to draw the machine for that? See, so first I should draw the machine to accept the regular expression which has a start state and final state. Then I am going to introduce a new start state and new final state. So start state will connect with the start state of the machine, final state will connect with the new final state. Next, I am going to show one transition towards the final state with the epsilon, because it is a star. So this may occur 0 or any number of times. So if 0 times comes, then using this epsilon transition directly I am going to reach a final state. If the expression occur 0 or 1 or any number of times, then it will enter the machine and that will be get executed by this machine by using this iterative method, or you can say the self loop. So here the self loop I am going to give from a final state of a machine to the start state of the machine. So assume that I am going to accept the A star. So this is a machine to accept the A. Okay, so this is a start state of the machine, this is a final state of the machine. So I am going to show what? A loop from final state to the start state. So I will show the loop from final state to the start state. Next, I must introduce a one more state, that is a start state and a final state here. So next, this start state I am going to connect to a final state by using a epsilon transition. So this is my start state, this is my newly introduced final state. So I am going to connect this by epsilon transition. So this FSM accept what? A star. So if star indicate what? 0 or any number of time A occur in a language. 0 time means directly using this epsilon transition it reach from start state to final state. Next, If you want to accept AA, then so first, see, you should show the transitions here. First, with epsilon, it will reach the state 2. Then if 1A come, it will change its state to 3. Next, so with epsilon transition, it will move back. So here epsilon transition will come, move back, and it will again reach back to a 2. Then the second way will get accepted, and so on. So once it is over, then it will, using the epsilon transition, it will reach the final state. So this is the FSM to accept what? The clean closure of a regular expression. So remember all this. We'll see more example on this in the next video.